Hi beautifuls, let's go ahead and get started. So I'm taking the only white shade, it is a frost, and I'm putting that on my inner corner and I'm packing it because I want my inner corners to be very open and light looking. Before I recorded this video, I did do my brows as well as a light layer of the NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk as a base. So all I'm doing is packing that on. Now I'm taking the only matte shade in the Blush Nudes Maybelline palette, which is like a dusty rose shade. It's very pretty. And I'm going to start making a crease. And that's what I'm doing right now. I'm just laying the color with this flat brush. I'm not really doing a whole lot of blending yet. And I'm doing the same thing to the other side. I'm blending upwards a slight bit, but nothing too crazy. I'm going to go in with my fluffy blending brush in a moment to really diffuse that color. And I'm also going to take that color with my flat brush underneath my eyes because I want the same effect underneath the eyes. And there is my fluffy blending brush, and I'm just taking that and really working it back and forth and in circular motions to make sure it's really blown out. And I'm primarily using a back and forth motion as well as a circular motion and kind of going back and forth between those two to make sure everything is all blended. And I'm going back with a flat brush and making sure there aren't any harsh lines. I'm going to take the Maybelline 24 Color Tattoo. I love, love, love these products. As you can see, once I put it on my lid, it is so pretty. It is so pigmented. Honestly, you can wear this on its own. I had Bad to the Bronze and I just loved it for a quick, just like out the door lid stain, if you will. But today I'm going to be using this as a base. And earlier I did put NYX Milk all over my eyelid, and I'm just using this for an extra pop. And now I'm taking that flat brush and I'm going over my crease, making sure that color still does stay pigmented, and doing the same thing underneath my eyes. And now what I'm doing is I'm looking for the lightest pink shade that they have. And I found it. It's a very pretty, light, frosty pink shade. Putting that on my flat shader brush, I'm just going over that pink base that I put on. And you can just see how pretty it is and how it pops. And I just am so happy that I went with the Maybelline 24 Hour Color Stay. I think it really helped this look. And it is inexpensive. And like I said, you can just wear it on its own. And it's really simple and easy to use. You can even use your finger with it. And now with my fluffy blender brush, I'm just going back and making sure that that is all smoked out and looking great. And now for the outer V, I'm taking a purpley dark plum color, which also is not matte. It does have some shimmer, but I'm focusing it on the outer V so it won't be completely in the crease. So I'm just going back and forth and really focusing that right on the edges of my eye to give it some shape and depth, but nothing too harsh, nothing too crazy. Yeah, nothing too crazy, and I'm just really liking the way that that purple looks in the outer V. It's just giving it a really pretty color gradient, and I'm just really feeling it. So sorry that the shot was so bad, but I'm going to be taking a brown, a mid-tone brown, and I'm putting that on my lash line, and I'm slightly dragging it out to the V, but it definitely is not going anywhere near the crease, and it's kind of just like a upward slanted line that's connecting to the edge of the outer V, but that's all I'm doing with that. And now I'm taking the fluffy blender brush, and I'm going back over my crease as usual, making sure that that baby is still looking good. And now I've taken the white shade that I have on my inner corner, and I'm putting that right under my brow bone. I'm not going all the way in to like where my nose meets under my brow. I'm just going on the outer portion of my brow because I do want this to be a natural look. And now I'm taking the Jumbo NYX Pencil in Milk. I used to see this all the time on YouTube, and honestly, I don't really see it too much anymore, and I think it's a very, very good find. From the drugstore. I know you can order this online as well if it's not in your particular drugstore. So I just lined the waterline with that big white pencil, and I just love the way it just opens up the eyes and gives you that fresh, almost dolly look. So I curled my lashes, and now I'm using my favorite mascara. Sorry, I just get so excited. This is the Maybelline of Falsies. And honestly, I've tried a lot of higher-end mascaras, which are, you know, they're nice. They definitely do what they say they do, but nothing like this because the price is so inexpensive. And what it does, at least for my lashes, I love so much. So now I'm going to go ahead and grab my stippling brush and I'm going to apply my Clinique moisturizer all over my face, and I like to do this when I'm in a rush. I have very dry skin, so I wouldn't recommend stippling your moisturizer on every single day, but when you're in a hurry, it's okay. Now this NYX color corrector in a medium orange peachy shade I've been dying to use, but it has been sold out in my local drugstore forever. I just barely got my hands on it, so you can see I'm just using a little bit and I'm not making the typical V highlighting shape that I would do with like a concealer, because I'm only going to want to be putting it on the spots that need the treatment and need the help, and that's directly under my eyes. And now I'm going to be taking the Maybelline Master Prime Face Studio. This is supposed to be a primer that's supposed to blur and just make your skin look more vibrant, but I love to use it as kind of like a subtle highlighter. I find that when I mix creamy or liquid products like this, even powder products, powder bronzers, I have one from MAC that I love to use, but when I mix it in with my foundation, it gives me the most beautiful, subtle highlight. The kind of highlight that you see on people who aren't necessarily wearing makeup, but maybe they've been like perspiring, I guess you want to say, for a while. And when they turn their cheek or turn their face, all of the high points on their face are just naturally glowy. And that's what I love about this product. It has a light pinky tone to it. And you can see that now I'm directly taking a small amount of it. I have it right on my fingers and I'm just going over that, and I'm just dabbing that with my finger on the high points of my cheekbones as well as the tip of my nose and a little bit up to my forehead. I don't want to highlight that whole thing, but you know how it goes. My Cupid's bow, again on the cheeks, and I just love that product so much. I'm taking a Maybelline stick highlighter and I'm just going underneath my eyes, making that typical V shape that is very popular on YouTube, highlighting my Cupid's bow, and then highlighting my nose and a bit of my forehead. I don't have a fancy beauty blender. Hopefully soon I will. Right now I'm just using a drugstore sponge and just patting that on my skin, and I love how it is sitting over the Maybelline primer. It looks really pretty and it's giving it that great shine that I love. So I'm just going back and forth and patting motions, just making sure that it is all blended out and that there are no harsh lines. And now with the nose, sometimes when I have time, I really like to let it set into the skin. I think it looks really good. I didn't really have time today. So now I'm using my little blush brush and I'm picking up some of my Wet n Wild color, and yeah, as you can see, it was way more pigmented than I thought, but no worries. I went ahead and took my Kabuki brush and really just buffed that into my cheeks and into my skin. I was so shocked to see how crazy pigmented this Wet n Wild cheek color was. I've actually never used Wet n Wild, but it turned out to be awesome. So again, I'm not contouring because this is going to be a more natural look, but however, I am taking that blush color and I'm kind of putting it in the spots where I would contour, almost using it as a bronzer. So now again, I'm taking that Maybelline highlighter and just going over again what I've done with the cheek color, making sure that all the areas that I want highlighted are highlighted, like my cheekbones. And then I also think it's very pretty when people put a subtle highlight right, not in their inner corner, but right on the edge of their nose. It can be really pretty. And I dipped into that light frosty pink color, and I'm just going to go ahead and set that Maybelline primer and just go ahead and do the same thing on my Cupid's bow and my nose. So there you have it. As far as the skin goes, now I'm taking a Sonia Kashuk lip liner, lined my lips and filled them in as well, and I'm taking a NYX lipstick, and I believe this is the strawberry milk, and I'm just using a bit, putting that over the lip liner, and now using a NYX lip gloss, and I believe this is Eclair, and I'm putting that all over my lips for a juicy, shiny lip color. Thank you for watching this video. I had so much fun recording it. You guys are all beautiful. Remember that. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.